Today, we are going to use the soft glow double exposure montage effect to turn our photos into unique dreamlike works of art. In this tutorial, I'll walk you through the steps required to turn an image like this into something that looks like this using nothing but Snapseed from Google. For those who don't know, the soft glow double exposure trick is an image style that we can create internally with certain DSLR camera bodies or in post-production using software like Adobe Photoshop. Now, thanks to the brilliant minds at Google, we can easily create this dreamy look using nothing but our smartphones and our fingertips. To pull this trick off, you're going to need an image with lots of color and contrast. I find that the soft glow montage effect works really well with subjects like flowers and fall colors. Let's get started with this image here. To give this image the soft glow look, I'm going to need to blend this photo together with a blurry copy using Snapseed's new double exposure filter. Before I can create the blend, though, I need to create a blurred copy using Snapseed's lens blur filter. When lens blur loads, I'm going to use the two-finger pinch in move twice to make the center and transition zone for the elliptical blur tool as small as possible. Next, I'm going to tap on the word adjust in the center of the toolbar to bring out the flyout menu for this feature. I'll slide one finger to the right to set the blur strength to about 60. With a swipe down, I can change to the transition control. I'm going to swipe all the way to the left now to set this one to 0. For this purpose, we don't need any transition since we want the whole image to be blurry. With one more vertical swipe, I can switch over to the vignette strength control. Now, you certainly don't need to follow this step, but I like to increase the strength of the vignette that the blur filter introduces to around 50 when I'm creating this soft glow effect. As you can see, we have gone from sharp to blurry. Things are looking good, so I'm going to tap on the check mark in the bottom right corner of the toolbar to commit these changes. We could save our work right now, but I think it's worth adding one more set of adjustments first. When you blend color images together using Snapseed's double exposure filter, the results often show a lot more contrast and a lot more saturation than the original. Since this is already such a saturated high contrast image, I'm afraid that if we blend the blurred copy that we have now into the original image, then the results will be too contrasty. So I'm going to go to the Tools and Filters menu again, and then I'm going to use the Tune Image toolset to back things off a little here. In the Tune Image toolset, I'm going to start by tapping on the word Adjust on the toolbar, and then swipe down to the Shadows control. I'm going to set the shadows here to about plus 65. Next, I'm going to swipe up to the brightness, and I'm going to set it to about plus 20. I think I'll swipe down in our flyout menu again, set the contrast to about negative 30. And finally, I'm going to reduce the saturation to about negative 10. Obviously, the settings that I'm choosing right now are not going to be the right choice for every image. The point here is to take some of the contrast and intensity out of your blurred copy, but please, season to taste. This looks good to me now, so I'm going to tap on the check mark to return to Snapseed's home screen. At this point, I need to save a copy of my work. On iOS devices, be sure to use the Save a Copy option when this menu appears. On Android devices, have no fear. Save a copy is Snapseed's constant default behavior, which is great because it means that our blurred image will not overwrite our sharp original. Let me say that again, just to be clear. Our goal here is to use Save a Copy so that we end up with two photos, our blurred and our sharp original. Once we have both files, then we have the puzzle pieces that we need to create our montage. I find that it works best if we layer the blurred version on top of the sharp original. So the next step is to go open and then to pick the crisp copy of our image all over again. Once the sharp image loads, I'll go to Tools and Filters And then I'm going to swipe down to the new double exposure filter. Nothing exciting happens at first when the double exposure filter launches, because we have not told Snapseed yet which image we want it to blend with the one that you see on the screen right now. So step one in here is to tap on the Open Image button. Step two is to select the blurred copy that we just created. Now there's something to see. If you want, you can tap on the Style button, and then you can choose a different blending mode. I'm going to leave the style choices alone here and stick to the default for now, but I will use the overlay option on my next example. The opacity slider controls the transparency of the topmost image. If you slide this one all the way down to the left, then the topmost image, in this case the blurry copy, is completely see-through. With this set all the way to the left, our blur has no effect. But as I swipe this control to the right, the blurred version becomes less and less transparent, meaning we see more and more of it on top of the underlying sharp image. For this soft glow composite, somewhere around 60% looks great to me. I love it. Now we have soft, ethereal glow around our flowers. Now we have an image that looks more like a garden of dreams than just another everyday ho-hum shot of a bunch of tulips. If you're happy now, then the last step is to save your work. Again, I recommend using the Save a Copy feature on iOS devices. I'm going to jump over to my tablet's camera roll right now to show you what we've created. Here's our original sharp image. Here's our blurred and softened copy. And finally, here's our soft glow montage, where we see a little bit of sharpness and some of that beautiful blur around our photos. Awesome. I'm back in Snapseed, and I'm ready to do this again. Only this time, I'm going to use this fall color photo from the lovely coast of Maine. Now, to get ready for this demo, I've already created and saved a blurred and softened copy. I promise that I followed the exact same steps as last time using the lens blur filter and the tune image toolset. I saved my work in advance so that you don't have to watch all those steps over again. Instead, let's get right into the fun stuff. Since I've already prepared that blurred copy, I can go straight into the double exposure filter. Next, I can go Open Image and choose the blurred version just like we did last time. Now, I'm going to slide the opacity control up to about 70% this time. This time, I'm going to tap my way through the style choices to see what each of these different blending modes looks like with this pair of images. In my experiments, getting ready for this tutorial, I found that the overlay option looked pretty good here. This is a place where experimentation pays off, though. You never know what you'll get until you try each option. Compared to the default, overlay seems less hazy this time. I love what you see on the screen right now, so I'm going to tap on that check mark again to commit my work. Now we have a New England dreamscape, but let's add one final touch. In the original, there was some nice detail in the gravel along the road that seems to have been lost in the blurred version. I want to keep that part of the image the way that it was in the crisp original and let this soft glow montage effect shine through everywhere else. Well, when you want part of something here and part of something there, then it's time for the hidden Edit Stacks Masking Brush feature. I'll tap here on the Edit Stacks icon, and then down here on the View Edits option. Next, I need to tap on that tiny little left-pointed caret beneath the words Double Exposure, and finally on the middle paintbrush icon to open up the masking brush. As you may remember from some of my other tutorials, it will appear at this point as if the change, our soft glow effect, has completely vanished. Don't panic. All I need to do now is to tap on the Invert button so that Snapseed knows that I want the double exposure glow to be visible everywhere on this composite again. I'm going to tap on the mask icon here to show you the red overlay. Remember that in this app, where there is red in the mask, the effect that this edit layer calls for is visible. It's active. In this case, that means that our soft glow right now is visible everywhere. So, if I want to prevent this soft glow from happening over one part of my image, then I need to paint over that area with something other than the 100% strength brush. I'm going to tap on the decrease arrow a few times until I have the zero strength brush. Now, I'm going to use the two-finger pinch in move to zoom this image out a little bit. Remember in Snapseed that your masking brush automatically grows larger as you zoom out, and that the brush grows smaller the more you zoom in. Remember too that if you press and hold two fingers against the screen, that you can see the size of your brush tip. With the zero strength brush, I'm going to paint a little here. As I get further away from the front edge of the road, I'm going to switch over to the 25% brush and zoom in a little bit to bring a hint of that soft glow into the distant end of the road. I'll tap on the mask again and switch my brush around if I need to do a little cleanup at this point. There's no need to get too precise in here. So with just a couple of paint strokes, I think I'm done. Let me commit my work with the checkmark button. Now, I'm going to tap that little arrow in the top left corner to return to Snapseed's home screen. Before, we had a nice standard travel shot. After, we have this amazing fall dreamscape with a hint of detail still in the road to draw your eye in. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial and that you feel inspired now to play with the soft glow double exposure montage effect on some of your mobile photos. As you experiment, don't forget to save, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.